Well, I always knew it was real, and I always knew that it was big.
Yes.
I didn't need any measurements in the newspaper to tell me that Bigfoot weighed a lot or that he was tall.
Absolutely. You know, I think there's a whole dimension of critters and creatures that exist if you unblind yourselves to them.
Yeah, dude. Magnum.
Yeah, or Bigfoot's just got the tiniest dick ever.
Yeah, it's either one or the other.
Yeah.
Either a Magnum or just like one of those pinky condoms.
Yeah, I mean,
finger condoms.
Bigfoot might just have a vagina, for all I know.
That's what they should measure, his dick.
Yeah. Oh, you saw Big Dick over there? Another Big Dick sighting in the woods.
That would be a lot more interesting than telling me how tall he is or how fat he is.
Yeah, let's. Who are we bullshitting? Let's stop beating around the bush.
I could just watch Harry and the Hendersons and get a better idea about, you know, the size of him. But Harry never really asks or tells how big his dick is in that movie.
Harry is an appropriately named...
Is that real?
It's legitimate athleticism. I mean, they look a little, well, granted, they look a little stupid doing it, but
I'm going to be on the opposite end of the spectrum with them. I think it's stupid.
All right.
I didn't even know that really existed.
These guys walk so fast. It's unbelievable. And they get this sort of shimmy and sway as they do it.
I'd be more impressed if they could get on their hands and knees or hands and feet like a dog and run. That would be impressive. Walking fast, not impressive.
Olympic
dog. You ever had
mimicry.
To shit at Warped Tour?
Yes.
I bet I could beat all of those fucking.
That's actually
Olympic
fair.
Walkers.
The morning dash to the Virgin Porta Potty.
Yeah.
It is. I would say a power walk.
Sometimes I just get some tape and make a sign that said broken, and then at the end of the day, I know I got a fresh little porta potty to go.
Look at that deception and lies.
The easiest, I think, the easiest way to take a shit on a Warped Tour is you take. Wait, are we not allowed to say that? Okay.
Ooh. Well, we are allowed to say shit.
Bethany, you gotta cover your ears. The easiest way to take a shit on Warped Tour is you go, I don't know if you know about this, but you go to the back lounge and you take your back lounge garbage can out, and then you just go in front of the bus. It's perfect height.
You just
take the shit right in the garbage can, then bag it up and just leave it.
That's amazing.
By the recycling, because the people that pick up the recycling pick up the garbage too.
And they just
then you just put a fresh bag in the garbage can, you go put it back in the lounge, and nobody knows.
That's amazing.
Except for you and your butthole.
Yeah, and you know,
both feel a lot better.
Yes, and the dozen or so viewers.
Right, right.
These guys
generally,
have.
You want to do this at night.
Yeah. Actually, an addendum on the side, if you think that you're going to have a particularly smelly poo, and you are in the avenue of being courteous to people, which is not common, but whatever, we call it the aqua poo. You fill the bag with a little bit of water. And it takes away the smell.
Dude, have you noticed that a dry shit smells way worse than a shit that's submerged in water? That's why there's water in a toilet bowl. I guarantee you, if you were to take a shit right here on this table and then take a shit right here in this, but if this was filled with a little water, that would smell way less than that shit.
Yeah, oh, agreed, agreed.
That was easy.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. That myth is busted.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, a shit is sort of like a fart incarnate, you know? So it's gonna reek, and it's generally is less consistent than you think it is.
Last night after I threw up those 27 hot dogs, I contemplating shitting my pants right there because everything just hurt so bad. And it wasn't that my stomach was full that I threw up. It was that the taste of the hot dog was so gross, it started to make me gag. It was like the nastiest thing I'd ever had in my mouth. If there was ever a time I ever thought about becoming vegetarian, well, last night was the time.
Did you have a hot dog today for lunch at catering?
Fuck no. You know what I had? I was like, you know what? Fuck that. I'm not eating a hot dog. I had a Snickers bar, a mandarin lime, and a blue tea.
Wow.
You know, I was sad. I feel way better.
Yeah, there you go. I think sometimes you need to flush out the old system.
I still have to shit. I might have to leave this interview just to go take a shit.
I would totally just do it right now.